Welcome one more time to the Tecnodigital School. In the previous videos, we explained how to create our own scripts to generate sketches automatically. We can run this script going to File, Run Script. My Sketch Spiral 2 is the name of the latest version. And if we go to Sketches and we double click here on Sketch Spirals, we will see the sketch that we created. In this case, it is based on one spline that we copied and rotated to have another spiral here on the right side of the viewport. And we also explained how to extract data from the vertices and the geometry that make our sketch. In this video, we will see how to interact with our sketch here on Abaqus using the command line interface that we have down here. Kernel Command Line Interface, or CLI. And now let's open this sketch again, Spirals, to modify it. So let's double click here. We can refer to this sketch from the Python console here. If we write s equals mdb.models model1.sketches. And now if we write sketch spirals, we will have this sketch. So variable s is the sketch called sketch spirals. As we already know, we can look at the geometry of this sketch and we could say s.geometry. And if we want to know how many geometry features we have in this sketch, like lines, splines, circles, etc., we can just write len s.geometry. And like so, we have two splines in this case. Let's add one more line. Let's come here to create lines. We will add this line from the interface from Abaqus, and we can go from 0, 0 up to this vertex here. Okay, let's cancel this operation. And let's ask again how many geometry features we have in this sketch. So len s.geometry. And we see that we still have two geometries. It is not taking into account this last line that we have drawn in this sketch. And why is this happening? Is it not updating the s variable down here? No, that's not the problem. The issue is that when we modify, when we edit one sketch that is already created, the sketch that is opened is not actually called like this. It's not called in this way sketch spirals. It has another name, a temporary name. And what is this name? If we go back to MDB models model1.sketches, we can check all of the sketches that are already available by writing dot keys, since sketches is kind of a dictionary. If we hit enter now, we can see that we have the sketch spirals and we have another sketch called underscore underscore edit and two more underscores. And we cannot see this name below the sketches group in the tree because it starts with two underscores. It's a hidden name, it's a hidden sketch. But in fact, this is the sketch that we see on the viewport. So if we say s equals mdb.models model1.sketches, and we access this edit sketch, and now we write len s.geometry, now we have three geometry features. Now we can read on real time whatever we do on the sketch on the viewport. So we could say s.geometry.keys and we have the keys 2, 3, and 4. So key number 4 is this last line that we have created. So we say s.geometry 4 curve type, we see that it is a line. While the other, for instance, geometry number 2, it is a spline. So remember, this edit is used to refer to the current sketch that we have on the viewport in case we are modifying some previous sketch. And once we close this sketch, let's hit done, that temporary sketch called edit disappears, doesn't exist anymore. If we look again at the keys of all the sketches and we hit enter, we see that we no longer have that edit sketch. The sketch spirals has been updated with this edit sketch. When we create a new sketch, let's double click on sketches. Let's call it sketch new, for instance, continue. And let's make a couple of lines or circles, for instance, here and here, and one more line down here. Okay. Where is this sketch? It's already the sketch new. Well, let's check that. If we write again FDB models sketches.keys, we see that we don't have yet the sketch new. However, we have this profile sketch. So if we want to access these circles and this line or whatever we do in this sketch from the command line interface down here, we have to do the same as before. But in this case, we will write s equals mdb.models model1.sketches. Quick tip to autocomplete, for instance, to look among the keys of the sketches. After opening the square bracket, we can hit tab. It will autocomplete with the keys of the sketches. So we have profile, hit enter, and now S is the sketch called profile. It's a temporary sketch. So just to confirm this, let's say len s.geometry, and we see that we have three geometry features, two circles and one line here. And we can also create geometry, vertices, whatever, from the command line. Down here, we could say s.rectangle, for instance, and then we have to provide two vertices. For instance, the first vertex could be 0, 0, and the second vertex could be 20, 10. Enter, and there we have the rectangle that we have just created. And of course, now the number of geometries that we have is 3 plus 4 lines from this rectangle. So it's 7. When we hit done, it will rename this profile sketch into the sketch new that we specified at the beginning. So again, on the command line interface, clicking the up arrow, let's go upwards. And if we look at the keys available now, we only have the new and spirals. The profile has been renamed into the sketch new. And I would like to emphasize that we will never visualize here the edit or the profile sketches, because when we use these two underscore at the beginning of the name, it will be a hidden object. We will never visualize it on the tree. So I hope this clarifies and helps you debugging your scripts and the generation of your sketches in case you have many features and you want to check on real time what happens when you apply certain sketcher commands. And this was all for today. See you soon in the next video. Bye.